this behind me is the Union Chain Bridge. And it looks like a normal bridge, doesn't it? Oh, come off it. It's absolutely remarkable in its own way. There's a narrow strip of tarmac suspended over the River Tweed. One lane, no traffic lights. You probably wouldn't even slow down if you were driving across it. But that bridge is historic, because not only is it the oldest vehicle carrying suspension bridge still in use anywhere in the world, but if you look closely, you'll see something else. This side of the bridge, this is England, and that side of the bridge, well, that's Scotland. And for more than 200 years, this fragile looking piece of ironwork has connected two different countries. The Union Chain Bridge opened in 1820. It was designed by a man named Captain Samuel Brown, a Royal Navy officer who'd started experimenting with wrought iron chains to replace rope rigging on ships. Turns out, iron chains don't just hold up sails, they can also hold up bridges. Brown's idea was radical. The Industrial Revolution was in full swing. The people were starting to think in iron and steel instead of stone and timber. Suspension bridges were being tried here and there, but none had ever carried anything bigger than a horse and cart. Yet this one did, and still does today. Captain Brown's bridge used wrought iron eye bars linked together to form the chains that suspend the deck. Each one forged and assembled by hand, like the links in a massive mechanical necklace. And at the time, this was the longest suspension bridge in the whole world, spanning 137 metres. That record only ever lasted a few years, but the bridge, that's still here. And yes, it can still take modern vehicles, slowly, carefully, but it can. Technically, it wasn't designed for modern cars or heavy goods vehicles or even campervans, but after over 200 years, thanks to careful maintenance and a massive restoration project completed in 2023, the Union Chain Bridge is still very much open for business. And it has to be, because the nearest alternative crossing is miles away. It links Horncliffe in England with Fishwick in Scotland, but in the early 19th century, this wasn't just a convenience. Back then, the River Tweed was a serious barrier. Ferries were unreliable, and detours could take absolutely hours. This bridge made trade easier, got farmers to market faster, and perhaps more importantly, proved that suspension bridges could actually work. And you have to imagine what this would have looked like to someone in 1820. Most bridges were made from stone, arch-shaped, solid, heavy, and safe. But this, thin iron chains vibrating in the wind, creaking underfoot, it must have looked like science fiction. Even today, if you're standing on it when a car goes over, you feel it move. Not in a dangerous way, but in a this bridge is still alive sort of way. By the time the bridge reached its 200th birthday, it was in trouble. Rust, structural weakness, the usual enemy of metal in the British climate. But in 2020, a full-scale £10.5 million restoration, funded by English and Scottish councils, heritage groups and even the National Lottery, took place. Chains were repaired, decking was replaced, and in 2023, the bridge reopened, stronger than ever. But still recognisably that same bridge that opened in 1820. And right about here, I'm standing on the border of England. Literally, the River Tweed is the border. Now that bridge isn't just a crossing, it's a connection, one that lasted over two centuries, through world wars, through new nations, new technologies, and yes, even through Brexit. The Union Chain Bridge was the first of its kind, and it's still here, not just as a relic, but as a reminder of what happens when bold engineering meets bold thinking. A suspension bridge for horses and carts, and now cars, still doing its job 200 years later.